Please welcome Chairman and Chief Executive Officer, General Motors Company, Mary Barra.
Well, thank you everyone for being here and for those watching via live stream as well. I'd like to start my session by kicking it off with a video. So if we could roll the video, please.
Looked at a thousand different pictures that your mother took of you. You see, I had this crazy dream last night. This man, he talked to me. He told me everything that's good and bad about my history. And the future looks good. I swear that you are the future. I say that you are the future.
Most amazing things happening in the environmental space, the energy space, the healthcare space, the entertainment space, the technology space are all happening in the space between the wheels of every vehicle GM is making right now.
We're all set for auto control.
I've been in the thank you. It's pretty exciting. I've been in the auto industry my entire life, and I am proudly from Michigan, where the automotive industry is woven into our identity. I wanted to share that video before we got started because it's important to set some context. The auto industry, as we know it, has been around for over 100 years. When automobiles were first adopted on mass scale, they weren't just features of convenience. They fundamentally reshaped our physical environment. They changed the way we live our lives for so many people, and they brought freedom. But they also brought unintended consequences, crashes that can result in both death and injury, pollution that is contributing to climate change, and congestion that swallows up all too many hours of our lives. These are very real problems at very large scale, but we have the technology and the expertise to solve them, and we do believe that the future looks good. We see the future of transformation that is one that is all electric, self-driving, and fundamentally, it is connected. And that's why I'm here today. Several members of our global cybersecurity team join me today, including Kevin Tierney, who leads our global cybersecurity efforts. Kevin and his team are huge advocates of RSA's work to address cyber threats around the world. I know this room needs no convincing that there are virtually no industries today that are not vulnerable to cyber attacks, and the auto industry is no exception. We are bringing to market technologies and features that are radically changing what vehicles can do for people and to improve their lives. At the same time, customers are bringing more devices into the vehicle and expecting seamless integration. Part of our job is to ensure that our customers and their data are always safe, secure, and private. Privacy is an extension of security that we fiercely protect. At General Motors, early on, we recognized the emerging risks and we proactively built a dedicated global cybersecurity organization that is deep, broad, and well-funded, with hands-on engagement from our board of directors. It's that important to us. We view cybersecurity not as an area we invest in for a competitive advantage. We see it as a systemic concern for our industry. I think you know the auto industry is fiercely competitive, but cybersecurity is an area in which we must, and where we do, act as a united front to collaborate and share best practices. Kevin chairs the U.S. Auto Information Sharing and Analysis Center, known as Auto ISAC, which provides a safe, trusted environment for participating members to create and share leading best practices for the entire industry. Collectively, we incorporate strong security measures into every phase of the vehicle development process. And as this group knows all too well, the threat landscape is continually evolving, with sophisticated attacks specifically designed to circumvent even the most robust defense systems. Our enterprise defense strategy has to be integrated and multi-layered, because when a cyber criminal only needs to be effective once, we must get it right 100% of the time. Appropriately, the theme of this year's RSA conference is the human element. All of you here today are the best and strongest line of defense in this ongoing, even more complex fight. So thank you for choosing this profession. We need millions more of you, and I'll touch on that in a few minutes. As I mentioned at the start, we believe we have big solutions needed for the big problems we face. At General Motors, our vision is to create a world with zero crashes, zero emissions, and zero congestion. It's not a pipe dream. We know it's achievable. The critical technologies that will make it a reality include electrification, autonomous vehicles, and connectivity. And cybersecurity is foundational to all of these. Let me share just one example. If you live here in San Francisco, you have likely seen some of the test vehicles from Cruise, and they are driving all around the city. Cruise is GM's autonomous arm that is developing and testing all-electric, self-driving vehicles here in San Francisco because of its challenging driving conditions. Human error is still responsible for 9 out of 10 vehicle crashes. When we get it right, and we will, what's at stake is the opportunity to virtually eliminate crashes and the significant human and economic costs they bring. It's pretty important. In our approach to autonomous vehicles, we decided early on that safety had to be a gating metric, and that's a part of everything we do at General Motors. For our customers, it means providing the safest products and the strongest cybersecurity possible, while also giving them greater convenience, better accessibility, and all while doing it at an affordable cost. We are pushing the boundaries of engineering and redefining what vehicles can do. Last month, Cruise introduced Origin, a purpose-built electric autonomous vehicle we jointly developed with Honda and Cruise, designed with more interior space to provide better, more consistent, shared experience than a conventional vehicle. The Origin has no pedals, no steering wheel, or backup human driver. Using highly specialized sensors and computers, it delivers superhuman performance at a reasonable cost. It features multiple layers of protection designed from the ground up, like the vehicle itself, by Cruise's own cybersecurity team, working in collaboration with GM's global team. We all know that all electric AVs will save millions of lives around the world and protect our planet. They are real, and they are going to help us rewrite the rules of personal mobility. But when it comes to promoting them to the driving public and to policymakers, the trust factor is equally important to the technology. Before consumers invest their trust in us, they want to be assured that AVs will operate safely and securely every time without being hacked by outside forces. A critical cyber breach involving any one company will be an incident that affects everyone in this space. It could severely undermine the consumer confidence in this type of mobility and even delay the industry's ability to share these benefits with customers and society. It's why we are so focused on industry-wide cybersecurity collaboration and shared solutions. Now, at General Motors, we spend about $100 million or over $100 million per year on cybersecurity. We look at the risks end-to-end, from the back office to all aspects of the vehicle. There are no shortcuts, and there is no one-size-fits-all solutions. We have nearly 500 men and women, including penetration engineers, cryptologists, mathematicians, data analysts, program managers, and true hackers. We're developing in-depth defense, monitoring and detection, and incident response capabilities that we continually test, rework, and refine. We've implemented this program in part with partners like HackerOne and its white hat hackers to engage more closely with the research community and identify vulnerabilities before they become an issue. It has matured into a formal bug bounty program that continues to further validate and strengthen our cybersecurity efforts. We know we can never be complacent and must always be benchmarking our cybersecurity practices against best practices, and always, always, always looking for ways to improve. Critically, we've also re-engineered our vehicle development process to include cybersecurity from the earliest stages of vehicle design, with multiple layers of protection to defend the vehicle and its systems. This year, we are introducing the first vehicle models with our new vehicle intelligent platform, or VIP as we call it. It supports new EV technologies, it supports active safety systems, over-the-air updates, 5G networks, and enhanced cybersecurity protections. We think of it as the nervous system for our vehicles. As I said, with all of the coding support from different computations that run hundreds of the features in your car, from something as simple as windshield wipers that automatically turn on when it rains, to our Super Cruise system, which is the world's first true hands-free driving system, VIP becomes essential in powering and enabling these features. Our VIP has the capability to deliver 4.5 terabytes of processing power per hour. While our vehicles include cybersecurity provisions built before the VIP architecture came into being, these are the first built with cybersecurity as a cornerstone. I want to point out that our cyber efforts extend well beyond the cybersecurity organization. We have an environment of cyber hygiene across the entire enterprise, including those who will never write a line of code, because our defenses are only as strong as the weakest link. At GM, thousands of software developers are fully trained in secure coding practices, and they are on the front line as they write the software to incorporate technologies such as Amazon Alexa and Google applications and services into our vehicles. We see them as a huge, vital extension of our cybersecurity team. We also work closely with our partner suppliers, tens of thousands of them, to ensure the integrity, security, and quality of our products. And we share the knowledge through the Cyber Readiness Institute. We collaborate with the medical device, aerospace, defense, and consumer electronics industries. And we've adopted the Commerce Department's National Institute of Standards and Technology, NIST, cyber framework, which was developed with a focus on industries vital to national and economic security. And in the past year, we entered into a cooperative research and development agreement with the U.S. Army Ground Vehicle Systems Center to strengthen our joint automotive cybersecurity expertise over the next 2 years, and this is a first for our industry. And we will be sharing key learnings with the Society of Automotive Engineers for the development of common standards for widespread benefit. So as you can see, there's a lot going on, a lot of collaboration, and going forward, we know we'll need even more. We know this is a marathon with no finish line. So let's get back to talent. We need more talent, a lot more. I'm sure you've seen the same statistics that I have. The estimates of unfilled cybersecurity jobs range from 1.8 million to nearly 4 million by 2022. Without the right people and the right tools, the security risks will be increasingly in this connected world and endanger all of us. For the long-term success of virtually every business that exists within a digital ecosystem, we must fill the talent gap. And not just with anyone, but with everyone. Women and minorities continue to be severely underrepresented in the IT and engineering fields, so we've started our outreach even earlier, as young as middle school, to encourage them to pursue rewarding careers. We're doing this by working with organizations encouraging students to pursue STEM careers and provide hands-on, real-world exposure to ignite their interest and help them see a path for themselves in this space. Last year alone, our work touched nearly 300,000 students and teachers across the United States. 2 years ago, working with the Society of Automotive Engineers, we introduced a new interactive student cybersecurity challenge and curriculum for middle school students across the country. Guided by teachers and volunteers from the cybersecurity team, the students learned how digital information is transferred and protected in their everyday lives, as well as how these concepts tie to STEM careers, especially in mobility. Beyond this program, our army of employees generously volunteer their time to support various STEM programs in local schools, presenting, teaching, mentoring, and overall just getting involved. If we want to cultivate young people to be part of our future, we need to invest in theirs. So I want to thank RSA for bringing us all here today and for your commitment to being part of the solution. This conference is an example of what we need more of, creating more awareness of the issue and emphasizing the need to work together to achieve what none of us can do on our own. It's a crucial time for the auto industry, but it's also an incredibly exciting time. We are undergoing transformation that has not occurred over the last 100 years. We need to leverage our collective strength and the institutional knowledge to move forward into a new age that is safer, better, and more sustainable for a future that looks good. So thank you very much.